Carrie. So my talk's a little bit different than Drew's. So I never really had that question of whether God exists. I was raised in a very devout family that attended Sunday Mass. We're the type of family that do the Mass schedule of like three parishes so that we could go to Mass despite sports and activities. So I was really fortunate enough that I grew up with a really good faith. But I had a lot of moments in my life where my perspective on faith has changed, where it's really deepened. And so what I want to talk to you guys today is about one of those experiences. So in thinking about how my faith has really influenced me, I think that for me, one of the greatest things that I found is how my faith has helped me through difficult times through suffering. I think it's kind of fitting that the first talk is kind of discussing about if God exists. And I think one of the typical responses to, if God exists, why is there suffering? And so hopefully I can kind of share my experience, and maybe if that is a question you struggle with, that maybe it'll give you a different perspective on that, of why God allows suffering to exist. So my story starts during February vacation of my senior year of high school, and I woke up with excruciating pain in my right leg. After about a week of this, I was diagnosed with sciatica from two herniated discs. So for those who don't know what sciatica is, you have the nerve that runs down your back that goes all the way down your leg. And what happens is that the discs, when they were herniated, they slipped and they were pressing on this nerve. It was causing excruciating pain. And so for the next couple of months, my life was miserable. To give you a perspective, I was prescribed oxycodone to help with the pain, and it took 3 to 4 weeks for me to just be able to sleep through the night despite taking that, because the pain was so bad. And it was another several weeks before I was able to actually get myself off of it. And the sleep deprivation wasn't even the worst part, even though that was miserable. I couldn't walk or stand up for more than a couple of minutes. I had this awful walk. I was like this hunched over posture, and I like kind of dragged my right leg because that was the only way I could kind of somewhat walk without like significant pain. Some of my friends made fun of me for it, so that was fun. And as a result, during this time, during my senior year, I actually spent a lot of time just completely by myself, really lonely and depressed. If I wasn't at school or if I wasn't at physical therapy, I was pretty much holed up by myself because I couldn't do anything. I really couldn't do anything. And it led to some really low points. At one point, just kind of lying at night because I couldn't sleep because of the pain, just kind of questioning if this was what the rest of my life was going to be like, and just thinking that I didn't know if I could go on like that. But eventually, the pain began to improve, and not only was I able to stop taking the drugs, like I said, my posture did gradually improve, and I was able to increase the duration for which I was able to stand and walk, so I could begin to function a little bit better. And I'm really fortunate because by the time May rolled around, I actually could function well enough that I was still able to go to my senior prom, and I was able to walk at graduation, which a few months prior was not something I was sure I was going to be able to do. And then about a month into the summer, the pain all came back. And I was so fortunate because 4 days after I got back from vacation, because this pain started coming back when I was on vacation, 4 days that I came back, I had an appointment with a surgeon that I'd been in talks with before, and I was in surgery another 4 days later. And I had surgery a month before coming to college, and my life has been significantly better. You can see that I'm fine, I don't walk with a limp, I don't walk hunched over. For the most part, I don't really deal with any pain except for a couple of minor flare-ups every now and then. So this has happened to me over 5 years ago at this point. And that experience has really stuck with me, and it's surprisingly something that I'm really grateful for. It might seem weird, like why would she be grateful that, she had this awful thing happen to her. But one of the things that when I look back at the story is I see God's hand in all this. Because I look back and the timing of everything could not have been better. The fact that it happened over February break, because I go to WPI, I was under I like school. I didn't miss school because it happened over February vacation. And the fact that just it improved when it did so that I was still able to celebrate the end of my senior year and still able to participate. But then the fact that I was able to get surgery right before coming to college. Like, none of my friends in college really knew that I had this surgery until I told them about this. So I really see God's hand in all of that. But in addition to having this opportunity to see how God can sometimes work in mysterious ways and still be with us, this has also really just changed my perspective on suffering in general. I think for a lot of us, we try to avoid suffering. But this experience really taught me that I could find God in suffering. Because during this time, at those moments when I'd be laying awake and there'd be no one there and I'd be by myself in pain, there was nothing else I could turn to except to God. And it was during that time where that was one of the first times that I was really able to just focus on God in prayer. Because I was so reliant on Him. There wasn't anything else distracting me. There wasn't anything I could do. So I was really able to turn to God. And that was kind of what it helped to start my relationship with God. It put me in a really good position so that I was able to continue that faith journey in college. So I'm a short talker, so this is towards the end of my speech. So the thing I really want to convey is that suffering is not a bad thing. Suffering and difficult times are not a reason to lose faith in God. It's actually our opportunity to grow closer to Him. It's our opportunity to realize that we are reliant on God in everything, and to take that time when we can't just easily distract ourselves with other things, to work to grow in that relationship with God. So, thank you for listening.
She said in her talk too, it's hard sometimes to understand why God allows certain things, does certain things. And He has the unique ability to be eternal, and we're not. So we want everything in our time. But when we look back after years, or months, or weeks, whatever it is, in certain cases, we see that His time really was the perfect time. Again and again, he knows how to love us. He knows when to love us. He knows when we struggle. He knows when we suffer. And He's with us. Even though sometimes it doesn't feel like it, He's right there. And it's our responsibility just to cast our cares on Him and let Him love us. Because He is love.
Come to the sea.
come to the